Hi, and welcome to this video where I'm going to explain to you very briefly an overview of what glitch.com is. Glitch, it's one of my favorite projects out there right now, today in the early 2021. And it's a really, really nice project because what it is a platform that allows you to host code projects that live online and that can be accessed from anywhere. But what is so special about Glitch? Well, turns out taking a bunch of code, like a web server or like some process that lives online, and putting it on a cloud service and making it run and making it accessible to the World Wide Web is actually not such a straightforward process. It involves a lot of control panels and SSHing and Linux machines, etc. So it takes a little bit of time to get familiarized with how to do that. And what's amazing about Glitch is that it makes it extremely, extremely easy to just with a couple of clicks to create a project that is already living on the cloud, that has an address, that has an URL, and that we can use to share with other people and to have that project running online. It is specifically designed, as far as this video, it is specifically designed for front-end web development. So it's very good at hosting static pages that are built on HTML and JavaScript, for example. And it is also specifically designed for back-end projects that are running on Node.js. Node.js is the runtime that is most popular these days for JavaScript projects and is very useful for running web servers, for running WebSockets servers, etc., etc. Developing and deploying Node.js projects is typically not very easy, and most of the services that are out there are have like a monthly fee, etc. Whereas, for example, glitch.com is free. So it's you can host very simple projects, especially for tinkering and for learning. It's a really good one. And also a feature that is extremely, extremely nice of Glitch is that it has this online editor. So I can edit the code online without having to upload any files from my system, whatever. And at the same time, it's a collaborative platform. So we can have multiple people working on the same document, writing code together and executing that code. So think Google Docs, but for code. It's extremely, extremely nice. And I cannot emphasize enough how easy it is to run a Node.js project without having to go through the complexities of deployment, running servers, etc., and for $0. So it's one of my favorite projects right there out these days for tinkering with basic web stuff. It's going to be is really, really nice, and I really recommend that you check it out. And I am recording this video in the context of a video series of a playlist that I'm building about WebSocket technology and about using WebSockets to coordinate processes and exchange data between different platforms. So I'm going to be using glitch.com to create a bunch of these servers and use that to connect different processes and exchange geometry and move things around, etc., etc. So it's going to be very nice. So in my next video, I'm going to explain how to log in, how to set up a basic web page, and how to set up a basic web server. And then in the next videos, in the videos afterwards, I will go into more specifics about how to upload a WebSocket server, how to write a WebSocket server on Glitch, and then how to write clients that connect to it. And it's going to be really cool because we will be able to create like a chat function or have like multiple people communicate and exchange data there. Okay, so if you like that, please follow me on the next videos on this playlist. Thank you.